Здравствуйте! If you have an interest for the world of game hacking, you must have at some point wondered what the legalities of this awesome field are. Whether you are planning on selling or using a gameplay experience enhancing software, it is good to be informed. Now, keep in mind that in most cases, you only run a legal risk if you distribute such work. First way, it is in no way illegal to reverse engineer or make any form of modification software for a game, as long as it does not incorporate copyrighted code from the source. In most cases, such software will use its own algorithms, and in cases of copying or manipulating memory of a game, it will do it only temporarily. In 1992, the American company Galoob was sued by Nintendo because of their NES accessory, the Game Genie, which was a tool that basically allowed you to plug an NES cartridge in it and plug the whole thing in an NES and modify the game values and memory. It was basically a predecessor to what everyone knows as cheats to this day. Nintendo claimed that their device was breaking copyright laws by making derivative work. Derivative work is work based upon pre-existing work, like translation or art recreation. Basically, it's any work which transform or adapted original work. The court ruled that the Game Genie was not derivative work since its changes were not permanent. This reflects a lot with nowadays cheats, since this is even to this day how they all fundamentally work, so derivative work is out of the question. The next thing that comes to mind is the Digital Millennium Copyright Act, or for short DMCA, which is a copyright law introduced in the United States in 1998. This act had for goal to protect the copyright holders. It made it illegal to bypass copyright protection technologies. The problem is understanding what comes down to a copyright protection technology. Can an anti-cheat be considered as such? If yes, then one will risk breaching the DMCA, since most multiplayer games nowadays have some form of anti-cheat and one must bypass it in order to effectively distribute gameplay enhancing software. I wasn't able to find any legal case where a game company sued somebody because they bypassed their anti-cheat. A more obviously legal scenario would be cases where the cheating software's functioning falls under cybersecurity acts. An example where functionality of such software would be a cybersecurity offense would be if it allowed players to obtain content or do things by exploiting vulnerabilities on the server side of the game. Making exploits which send malicious payloads which crashes the server of a game would obviously be considered as a criminal offense, as denial of service attacks, no matter the form, as you all know, is obviously illegal. So in conclusion, making gameplay enhancing software is not illegal as long as you don't break cybersecurity laws, but you must keep in mind that most game companies are giants who make immense amounts of money. And money is a big factor in any lawsuit, as those with such money have a lot of power. They will absolutely shred you to pieces, eat you, digest you, and defecate you and everything you have if they wish. But in most cases, you will be fine if you sell, since to really get their attention, you need to be a big fish. And there are a lot of sellers out there in this community. So cases where a cheat developer gets sued by a gaming company is not that common. Thank you for watching this video, and especially thanks to my patrons for supporting me. Stay healthy, and I'll see you in the next video.